On April 11, 2023, at 1:35 a.m. local time, a major explosive eruption occurred at the Sheveluch volcano in Russia, representing the Kamchatka Peninsula's most powerful eruption in 30 years. As a section of Sheveluch's lava dome exploded, it sent a sustained plume of ash to a height of 54,000 feet or 16.5 kilometers, with the possibility that a section of the plume reached even higher. Due to the sheer amounts of ash ejected into the atmosphere, hundreds and perhaps thousands of lightning strikes then occurred in rapid succession, lighting up the sky, which otherwise turned a gray color. As this ash-rich gray plume drifted to the west, ash quickly piled up, reaching more than 10 centimeters thick in some areas, essentially covering everything in a thick brown layer. This sustained eruption continued at a high rate for at least 6 hours before finally becoming intermittent and then going back to weaker eruptive activity. What had just occurred was a sub-plinian eruption of the Sheveluch volcano. Before I continue, I want to give my opinion on the dangerous situation at this volcano. I do not work for the Russian government and do not have the authority to order any evacuations. With this being said, in my opinion, you should for the time being not be within a 15-kilometer radius of Sheveluch's active lava dome in all directions, expanding the 35 kilometers between 192 and 339 degrees if straight east represents 0 degrees and north represents 90 degrees. As you can see, the Sheveluch volcano has two large collapse scars open towards the south and south-southwest. The area I have labeled is the active lava dome, so any eruptive products or superheated gas currents will originate from there. Thus, if this vent was to suddenly produce another major eruption, any pyroclastic flows it would generate would for the most part travel within the confines of its two major collapse scars. Only the largest pyroclastic flows might spill over these walls, but would be unlikely to travel more than 15 kilometers. On the other hand, pyroclastic flows, lateral blast deposits, and large debris avalanches caused by sections of this volcano collapsing have reached up to 34 kilometers distant during eruptions since the end of last ice age. You can tell this via numerous rounded hills which seem out of place on the southern flanks of this volcano. These hills are referred to as hummocky terrain and are a telltale sign of a debris avalanche having occurred at least once before, much like these hummocks which originated 340,000 years ago at Mount Shasta. And yes, I will acknowledge that it is highly unlikely the current eruption or any activity in the next week will reach 35 kilometers distant. Rather, 35 kilometers is what, in my opinion, I deem to be a mostly safe radius in case of a worst-case scenario eruption. For context, Sheveluch during the Holocene Epoch, aka the last 11,700 years, has been the single most explosive volcano on the planet when you count the number of eruptions it has produced that were at least on the same order of magnitude as the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens, as it has produced 15 of those. Based on early indications, I am suggesting that the latest eruption registered in on the Volcanic Explosivity Index scale is a 3, perhaps even being a low 4, although I consider the latter to be less likely. I had previously reported on early warning signs of a near future major explosive eruption at this volcano all the way back on November 22, 2022. Although Sheveluch was already erupting at that time, it underwent a rapid increase in thermal signatures visible from satellite, suggesting that a new and large gas-rich body of magma was intruding into the volcano. Yet, these increased signatures then returned to normal levels. I thus believe that the highly volatile and gas-rich shallow body of magma was still present but remained trapped under the more than 1,000-foot thick viscous lava dome and built up over the time span of 6 months before finally breaking overlying rock and causing this eruption. Thus, I fully expect a small section of Sheveluch's primary lava dome to be missing, perhaps with a new 100-ish meter-wide explosion crater carved into it. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Dr. Buckton for becoming a new patron on this channel's Patreon page.